Well, does anyone want to know about my day? I had the best day.
No, just shut up, okay? We're trying to watch this.
God, call me stupid. I'm sorry.
Maybe we should meet here in 5 years or something.
All right.
What are we going to do tomorrow?
5 years.
Well, nothing now.
Like what were you supposed to do?
Go out with Ash.
Sweetheart, we already talked about this. This guy is too old for you. He's almost as old as your mom. I love you.
Could I have some money for tonight?
Sure. It's okay, honey. I knew who I was marrying. I fell in love with her.
Martha, the phone.
Oh, sorry, I was just... Thanks.
Martha, by the way, this Ash guy, maybe I judged him too quickly. But we'll talk later.
I had no choice, and I love her. You know, she's not perfect, but who is?
Look at it, honey. Put the knife down. Put it down. Oh, yeah. Very nice. Put the knife down.
Ned, it's Jeffrey. I think I forgot my, what was it? Oh yeah, my jacket. I got home and I didn't have it. Could you see if it's there? Because I really like that jacket. I mean, it's really special to me. My boyfriend, Jamal, gave it to me. It was a present for my birthday. It was really nice. Oh, thanks.
Hello.
Can I come in, Mr. Allen?
Whatever.
I just want to have a quick talk about something.
Talk? What do you want to talk about?
Why don't you have a seat? Mr. Allen? I'm actually here to talk to you about your wife.
You found her.
Found her?
I mean, she didn't come home last night.
Well, in fact, that's why I'm here. We can't we can't find her. I'm actually just doing this as a favor for a friend of mine, Jeffrey Tracy. I'm not even on duty right now, hence the garb. Do you know Jeffrey?
Yeah, well, Deb and Jeff are friends.
Yeah, well, Jeffrey seems pretty concerned about your wife. He says that he was supposed to meet her for lunch today and she never showed up. That he even called her dentist, who she had an appointment with, and they haven't seen her either. So I was just, I don't know, wondering why you haven't mentioned her disappearance to anyone.
Well, Officer...
Martin, but you can call me Haley.
Officer Martin, is it, you know, well, this really isn't a unique situation. It really happens all the time.
I see. So she never came home last night?
Never.
Okay. Well, Jeffrey seems pretty sure that she did. He says that they were here for quite a bit.
Well, Officer, You are aware of Jeffrey's drinking problem, right?
I am. Look, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm just doing a favor here. And it seems like this is a pretty normal occurrence, so why don't you just call me if anything happens. If she doesn't show up, I'd be really happy to help, right?
Wonderful, thank
Great.
You.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Maybe I'll be seeing more of you.
It's terrific,
yeah.
Excellent.
Great.
Thank you. Thank you, Officer Horton. Martin.
Where is she? Deb? Deb?
I don't know.
Yeah, well, maybe Haley buys that, but I sure as hell don't.
Haley? Oh, the officer you sicked on me.
Of course, her. Now, what did you do to Deb?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What was it, huh? Did you figure out that she didn't love you anymore, that you didn't love her?
How dare you tell me how I feel? Look at Sherlock. The marriage wasn't perfect, but why would I ever hurt her?
Because you hated her.
So why wouldn't I have left?
Maybe because she was good in bed.
Ned?